Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about general theory and the production of X-rays. So how X-rays will be produced? When high velocity electrons will strike on the metal target, then it will produce the X-rays. This video is sponsored by GPAD Discussion Center. Visit JDC for GPAD.com for details about GPAD, NIPER, Drugs Inspector and Pharmacist exams. Use Dr. Puspendra Classes coupon code, that is PK25, and get 25% discount in all online test series of GDC for GPAD.com. So, process of producing X-rays can be explained by using the Bohr's theory of atomic structure, and it will be like this. So this is the structure of an atom, and this atom contains nucleus, and in nucleus we are having protons and neutrons, and we are having various cells like K, L, M, N and so on, and this cell contains different number of electrons. And if we are talking about this K cell, then it will contain, it is, as it is first cell, so it will be 2N square. Here N is the sequence of cell number, so it will be 2 into 1 square, so ultimately we are having 2 electrons in this K cell, which is represented by black color. Here you can see that 1 and 2 electrons are present. If we are talking about L cell, then it will contain 8 electrons. If we are talking about M cell, then it contains 18 electrons. And if we are talking about N cell, then it contains 32 electrons. So these electrons will be present in different cells like K, L, M, N, O and so on. And the energy of the outer cell will be higher as compared to energy of the inner cells. Now if one electron, one high velocity electron will strike the atom, then it will knock out one electron from this atom, that is this one, and itself will be out from this atom. So due to this process, here this electron will be knocked out from here and it will go here. So here void will be produced and it will be vacated. So to fill this vacated position, electrons may come from this L orbital. Electrons may come from this M orbital, or electron may come from this N orbital. So whenever these electrons coming from L, M or N orbital, this one or this one, then it is coming from higher energy level to the lower energy level. So that will release some energy, and that energy will be released in the form of X-rays. And this released X-ray energy will be equal to the difference between the energy of two cells. If this vacated position is filled by electron from L cell, then energy of X-ray will be equal to energy of L cell minus energy of K cell. If energy falls from M cell, then energy of X-ray is equal to energy of M minus energy of K. And if electron will fall from this N cell, then energy of X-ray is equal to energy of N minus energy of K. So here EK, EL, EM and EN are energy levels of different cells, which are K, L, M and N. Now this concept can be easily understood by energy level diagram, which will be like this. So this is the energy level diagram to understand this concept. So here we are having high velocity electron which will attack on the electron of inner cell, which is 1s, and it will knock out one electron. So here one void space will be there. So to fill this void space, electrons may come from outer cells. If it is coming from 2p, then it is known as K alpha 1. If it is coming from again 2p, then it will be called as K alpha 2. If it is coming from 3D, then it will be KB1. If it is coming from 3D, then it will be K beta 2. If it is coming from 3P, then it will be K beta 3. If it is coming from 3P, then it will be called as K beta 2 and so on. And if this electron will knocked out one electron from this 2s orbital or 2p orbital, then what will happen? Then in that case, that this void space will be filled from the electrons coming from this m orbital. It may be coming from 3d, 3p, 3p, like this. So it will be go on like this, and there will be change in the energy. So this will be the change in the energy. We can tell that this is the delta E. So when these electrons are coming from higher level to lower level, then they will release some energy, and that energy will be emitted in the form of X-rays. So this is the basics or process of X-ray production. And the frequency of the emitted X-ray can be calculated by using this formula. So if an electron is dislodged from K cell, this is K cell, it may be replaced by an electron from L or M cell. So frequency of the emitted X-rays will be nu is equal to energy of L cell minus energy of K cell divided by H, that is Planck's constant. Or if we are talking about electron from M cell, then it will be nu is equal to Em, that is energy of M cell, minus Ek, that is energy of K cell, divided by H. If we are talking about this one, means electron is coming from this M cell to L cell, then frequency will be equal to Em minus El divided by H, that is Planck's constant. So by using these formulas, we can calculate the frequency of that particular X-ray. And by using this type of process, we will get the X-ray pattern like this. So this is the X-ray spectrum pattern of any target. This is only for representation. In y-axis we have taken relative intensity. So if we are going upside, then intensity will be increased. And in x-axis we have taken wavelength. If we are going to the right side, then wavelength is increasing. If we are coming from right to left, then wavelength will be decreasing. If we are going to the right side, then energy will be decreasing, and if we are coming to the left side, then energy will be increasing. So if we are taking this minimum wavelength, then it can be calculated by using the formula. So this lambda minimum can be calculated by using the formula H into C divided by E into V. Here H is the constant, that is Planck's constant. C is also a constant, that is velocity of electromagnetic radiation. E is the electronic charge, that is also a constant. So if we will put the value of H, C and E, then we will get 12,400. Here we will get lambda minimum in terms of angstrom. If we want to calculate the lambda minimum, means wavelength, in terms of nanometer, then it will be 1240 divided by V. And here V is the X-ray tube voltage. So this lambda minimum is also known as cutoff wavelength. If we are talking about lambda max, then it can be calculated by using the formula lambda max is equal to lambda minimum into 1.5. So this is the complete detail about general theory and the production of X-ray by using this process. But there is one another process for production of X-ray, and that process will be discussed in my upcoming video. Thank you.